in some countries in Africa, the condition of the population doesn't correlate with the resources of the country. So in my country, Congo DRC, people are suffering from the stuff, they are suffering from the disease, from the war, from the poor down. They are living in poor condition. So there are a lot of facts that bring those poor condition. 18 years ago, the country went into conflict. So it's a conflict, the army conflict, army groups, so bring the conflict. Then the Congo is a country of Africa, in Central Africa. Then we have like 9 countries surrounded on our border, like Angola, Burundi, Rwanda, Tanzania, Uganda, Zambia, Republic of Central Africa, Republic of Congo, but there are 2 Congos, Republic of Congo and
Nigeria.
Sudan, no Nigeria, Spain.
Sorry.
According to Dr. Shema, he is a doctor in political science from the University of Germany, India. The conflict of 1996 and 1998 in DRC I've reflected in a massive description of social, political, and economic fabric of the country. So then the same doctor with his research, he came to say that in the country, the resource of the country is the fact that makes more country to be fighting for those resources. So then the Dr. Shem said the conflict in the DRC is attributed to the misgovernance in the consequence lack of the democracy since the independence of the country. So the country was independent in 1960. So since there was good governance, there was the democracy, so the country was messed up. So today I'm going to tell about the consequence of the armed group in Democratic of Congo. So the first one is the killing and displacement. So the ongoing conflict in Congo, the conflict in Congo have aggravated the situation. Cause a lot of life, many lives, lost of many lives. So people were killed, so people were displaced, they lost their life. According to the Association African des droits de défense des droits de l'homme, is CASADEO, in 2000, a grant of human cost of the conflict can be gained by the following facts.
Don't read them.
Yeah. So is a statistic. On August 27, 1998, the BBC reports that 2,000 people were killed in South Kivu. South Kivu is the east part of Congo. So then the same BBC report that 1,818 people were killed in South Kivu also. They call it the massacre of Makobola, I can show them. So all those people were killed by the group army. So they went to the village, they killed people, then after that we're gonna discover those things. So after the killings, they made people to be displaced, to move from the region to the other one. So you can show the second picture. So this picture is showing people, they are moving from their place because of the group armies, they are going to another place. So most of them, they moved to the neighborhood country like Rwanda, Burundi, Uganda. So they left their place. The second consequence is the effect on the women. So as we know, in my country, the group armies, the armed group, they use women's like weapon of war. So to make people afraid, they are just come to the village, they take the women's, they rape them, you know, and then they kill them sometime. So there is in Bukavu, South Kivu, there's a Dr. Mukwege. Can you show the picture? Next one, the Dr. Mukwege is a gynecologist doctor in South Kivu. He's the one who is threatening those women. So after they have been sexually attacked or they have been raped, so he's taking care of them, so he's threatening them, but he's financed. They get some financement from the outside the country. Then he tried to help those women because they lost their hope, so they don't know where to go, they don't have what to do, so they lost everything. Then sometimes when those army group come to the village, they just take all the family. Then they order maybe a brother to rape his sister. If you don't do it, they kill you. Mm. They rape women in the front of their husband. They rape women in the front of their kids. So all of this make a fear in the country. So the next point, the third consequence is the impact in the economy. So by the group with the war, so the government lost many things. So lost many things, lost control of the parts of the country. Like in East there is, when the country is rich in minerals, so those armed groups, they try to control those parts to illicitly exploit those minerals. So they just take the copper, they just take the gold, they just take diamond. So that helped them to finance their activity. So then there is the United Nations report that there is some personnel of United Nations, they are implicated to the conflict. So they just try to help those group army to be able to continue to do those fights because they have their interests on the mineral. So in conclusion, I can say the killing of those people, the effect on women, the impact of the economic, so are all the consequences of the armed group. So the country need the help from outside. They need help from outside. Then you need like an implication of the government. So I can say the actor, government actor, like the minister, the president, all those people has to sit together. Then to think about something, to think about the interests of the country, to think about the interests of the population, so to try to give them a better hope for the future. And because those people are moving around, so the kids are not going to school, so people are lost of hope. So they need to sit together, then to include all the people. So because there is a separation, so there's like everybody want to take his part. So the president needs just his tribe. So the prime minister is think about his family, but they don't care about the population. So all of them, if they sit around, then they think about the interest of the population, then the nation can go further. Thank you.